give a huge Salt Lake Comic Con round of applause for Jody Benson.
And take a selfie with me.
Okay. Yeah, stand up, turn your lights on so it's gonna, the stars will shimmer.
Oh, that's so cool.
There you go. Ready, guys? On the count of three. One, two, three. Now, Jody, we want to do a professional. Yes. Can you stand right here? Just right there. Perfect, stand right there.
Okay.
Turn around.
Oh my gosh, this is so
cool. Right. Are you guys ready? We'll do one with our photo. One with our phone.
My phone froze.
Okay. I'm gonna look over here. Look away. How are you guys doing?
My phone is dying.
Oh, okay. 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 Okay.
I don't take this for my kids. Okay, just take the professional.
We'll do the professional photo right now.
Sorry.
All right, guys, get those lights on. Ready? One, two, three.
Oh my gosh. I'm blown away, thank you. My broken phone, sorry. I'll just set that down. Oh my
gosh.
Do I have a charger? No, I have a charger. It's just that it's frozen. You know, like you try to get a picture, so. Sorry, I love you guys too. This is so special. Oh, I get to sit like in a director's chair and everything.
Okay.
Oh my gosh, this is so exciting.
So I have to. Blow their minds away right away.
Okay. Sorry.
This is her very first con.
Love it. Taking pictures of babies and the costumes. I haven't gone out onto the floor yet, but I would really love to put my tennis shoes on and go in and around everything. Because I think I could shop till I drop here with my kids. That'd be so fun. It's amazing.
It is so true. You walk out, you gotta be careful though. When you walk on the floor, it's like your money just disappears.
Yes, exactly. My son was supposed to come with us, McKinley, with me, and of course, he was beyond thrilled to be able to come, and we just moved him into college on Saturday to SCAD Atlanta. Yes, I cried all the way home, boo-hooed. And so I went to pick him up last night from school, because he only lives an hour away from us, thank God, and to come to the airport. And because of the hurricane, his classes were delayed a week, so they had mandatory class today.
Aww.
Yeah, so he couldn't come. Boo school.
Salt Lake Comic Con, education.
Yeah. So he didn't get to come, so I'm by myself, sending the pictures all day. And they're all like, oh, my daughter's like, are you kidding me? You just got your picture with Dick Van Dyke. And he can still kick his leg up here. He's 91. And he can still kick his leg up to here.
So
it's crazy.
He came on this morning, and when we had him up on the stage, we were like, okay, we'll help him up the stairs. He literally bounded up and then danced across the stage. And I was like, well, okay
yeah.
then.
Oh, he can dance. Oh, yeah.
Absolutely. So let's go ahead. We want to talk about some things. You have such an amazing career. You've brought some of the most amazing characters to life. And I want to talk about my personal favorite, then we'll get into everybody's. Yes, Ariel. The thing is, though, tour guide Barbie.
Short-sighted retailers did not make enough glass to meet demand. The brilliant John Lasseter. John Lasseter and I played in the studio with Barbies, a box of Barbies, John and I. There was really no script for Barbie, and so he came with a box of Barbies into the studio, and he's like, what would she say? Oh, I don't know. So we started talking to each other with our Barbies, like this. And, you know, the producers, and they just started writing the stuff. So all that stuff of bye-bye, bye-bye now. Are they gone?
Did you do that?
That's all ad-lib.
Did you start doing the voice? Did you just know it right off the bat, or did you have to do different type of variations?
Well, it's really funny, because I didn't audition for the movie, which is really weird. So I just get a call from my agent going, John Lasseter would like you to do the voice of tour guide Barbie in Toy Story 2. I was like, why? I mean, that was like, why? Well, he heard you do Ariel, and I said, he wants Ariel? No, he doesn't want Ariel, but he knows that Barbie's inside. He can hear her. I was like, if she's inside, can you tell her to come on out? Because I certainly don't know what to do. So I have no idea. So I basically, just because I'm a Broadway stage actress, I went old school and I went into the recording studio and I just decided to be like a plastic doll. So I like made my body like Barbies, and so that's just kind of how it came. That's just kind of how we created it.
It's amazing. It's amazing. Now, what you don't know, there is so many people here who would like to ask you some questions.
Sure.
Ask you some questions. All right, so let's go ahead. First question right here.
Oh my gosh, this is so professional. It's like a game show.